Are you new to prepping and you feel like everything is just too overwhelming, like there's just too many areas and too much stuff and you just don't have enough money to get started, and I really want that bunker in my backyard, or I watch this show and oh my God, they said I have to have all this stuff, and the news says the world is coming to an end and I'm freaking out and I don't know where to... Take a breath, man. Take a breath. Stick around. I'm going to give you 5 steps on how to like start prepping or take your prepping to the next level. Affordably, within your budget, easy, simple, nothing crazy, no panic buying, none of that. Normal stuff for normal people to be prepared for, like, everyday most common inconveniences. Stay with me. What's up, warriors? This is Kyoshi Dave Herman with 5 Elements Tactical Training, here to share with you some warrior skills and drills that anyone can learn and everyone should know. If you're new to the channel, welcome and thanks for stopping by. If you already follow us on social media and that's how you find your way over to this channel, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and the bell notification button and the little thing where it says all notifications so YouTube will let you know when the next video drops and you get all sorts of cool content from here as well. All right, so in the last few weeks, I've been doing a lot of work with YouTube, at my dojo, anybody that'll listen really, on September is Emergency Preparedness Awareness Month or something like that. So I'm going over go bags and what stuff you should have in your like blackout or power outage kit and all that stuff. And the people who are new to this stuff, it looks very overwhelming, but I didn't just start it yesterday. I didn't start a week ago. I've been doing it for a long, long time. And the stuff that I have, I didn't get all at one time. So a lot of my friends and students and subscribers have been asking, like, where do I start? So the first thing you need is a goal. Like, what are you preparing for? Like, if you're preparing for the zombie apocalypse, you're probably gonna need a whole bunch of stuff. If you're preparing for like, the world after doomsday, you're gonna need a whole bunch of stuff. If you're preparing for like, well, geez, you know, it's hurricane season and, you know, sometimes we get a hurricane and it knocks the weather, the power out, or we get a blizzard probably at least once a year that like knocks the heat out of the house or something like that. So if you're starting with a much smaller goal or a much more specific goal or a much more common goal, it's going to be a little bit easier to prepare for that. So the first thing you need to do is think of like where you are like on the globe and what things are probably most common. You know, could a zombie apocalypse happen? I guess. And should you be prepared for it? I think so. But is that common? Not so much. So start with the things that like whatever you're scared of, whatever like... I don't want you to be scared. Like most normal people, you want to be prepared. Like you learn how to swim in case you fall in water this deep, you don't drown, right? You put your seatbelt on. Like I'm probably not going to crash today, but if I do, I want to have that thing on. It's better to have a plan and not need it than need a plan and not have it, right? Same thing goes for your preps. So once you have your plan, the next thing you need to do is kind of make your list, right? What's the stuff that you think you'll need for you? So when I have friends that ask me like, hey, if I give you some money, could you make me a go bag? No, that's not how that works. Or, hey, if I give you money, like I'll give you my credit card number. You just like fill up my Amazon cart and get me a power out kit. Like one of those kits, those crates that you have in your house, like for when the power goes out. I'm like, that's not how that works either. I even have some business owner friends who are like, they got tons of money and tons of ideas and they love to see businesses take off. And they're like, hey, dude, you know a lot of stuff about this stuff. Why don't you like build kits and sell them? I'm like, that's not how this works either. Could I make kits and sell them? Sure. There's people out there that do it. But you know what's going to happen? You're going to get that kit. You're going to look at it and be like, I don't even know what to do with half this stuff. Or this is not designed for me or my family or my kids or whoever. So your kit has to be designed for you. What's the stuff that you need? So you're going to go to that list. A while back, I made a video on like how to start prepping or prepping for beginners or one of those things. A few months back, I'll put a card up here. You click on it. It's a little bit long, but it had a lot of information with a lot of ideas for each of the categories. And in that video, we talk about 5 different categories. And the first one is basically food and water. The second is going to be your clothing for like your environment and the climate and the season. The third one is your health and hygiene items. The fourth one is your comfort items. And the fifth is survival gear. Now, depending on what you're preparing for, those lists are going to be very different. Depending on the people in your house and the people that you are trying to make comfortable in the event of some sort of like natural disaster or tremendous inconvenience or whatever catastrophic thing happens, your list is going to be different than mine and the person next to you and the next guy down the line. I would make a list of stuff that you know that you use. So as far as groceries, well, that's an easy thing. Like, go look at your last, you know, four or five, you know, grocery receipts. And I bet most of the stuff is pretty common. The same things you get all the time. The last several times you went to the pharmacy or Walmart, Kmart, BJ's, Costco. Do you guys have Costco where you are? I love Costco. Check out your last, like, handful of receipts from all the stores that you, like, typically shop at. Now, survival gear, man, I have survival gear, like if I'm going to go camping or hiking or something, the stuff that I'm going to carry with me all the time, that if I have some sort of emergency that I'm good to go. I have the stuff that I keep in my car in case my car breaks down. And then I got the stuff that I keep in my house in case the power goes out or, God forbid, if there was some sort of crazy thing coming and I had to grab a few things, throw it in the car and go. My go kits. But again, those things are outfitted for me and my family and our needs, where yours needs to be for you. So once you have your goal and you have your lists for each of those categories, the next thing is, and this is pretty simple, take a look at what you already have. Like, go through like your house, your garage, your attic, your basement, your car, your pantry, and take a look at what you already have in stock, because that doesn't cost anything. You already have it. Just start organizing it. So one, you'll know what you already have, what you have plenty of, what you're a little bit short on, and what you really need. Once you know what you need, it gives you a better idea for like the next time you go on Amazon or the next time you're at Costco or any one of your big box stores, your grocery store or whatever. Now, the fourth part to this is shop on sale. You know, like when you're like, I live on Long Island, and every time they say there's going to be a snowstorm or something like that, there's this mad rush to get to the grocery store, and you get there and there's no milk, there's no eggs, there's no bread. Like, the biggest storm we have maybe puts us in this inconvenience for a couple days, so everybody goes totally nuts, like they're going to be buried under snow until, you know, springtime comes. But I also have a toddler who loves to have her baba and her milk, and if we're short on milk and we don't have it to give to her, it's going to be just like, oh God, Jesus, help me, please, please. So there I am with everybody else trying to get milk, like in line with all the crazies. Now, in my pantry, I have that shelf-stable milk that I could take that and use that, but I like to save that for like, oh my God, we're tapping into that. We're in a bad spot, you know. But when you're shopping in an emergency, one, you spend more money than you probably should. You probably buy more stuff than you probably need, and you're not in the right frame of mind. So it's not this calm, cool, collected, organized method of building your preps. But if you have a list and you know exactly what you're looking for, and you're not in any rush to get it, then you could shop the sales. Step four is shop sales. Hey, who doesn't want to make their dollar go further, right? As it is, everything is so much money. Gas is going through the roof, lumber's through the roof, ammunition's through the roof. So like all the things that I know that I use pretty regularly, man, like all that stuff is crazy expensive. So thank God along the way, I've shopped on sales and, you know, stocked up as best I could. But as I need it now, I'm not in a rush for it. I'm not panic buying. So if it's not an emergency and you're not panic buying, you have all the time in the world to like shop where things are less expensive to begin with. Like I like to go to like Costco and BJ's and Walmart and places where like maybe I got to buy it a little bit more in bulk, but the dollar goes further. And if I'm going to spend $5, give me a huge box of cereal, not the little one, that type of stuff. And then if I'm going to shop on sale, even better. If I catch a coupon and then I could use the coupon when it's on sale, even better than that. You follow what I'm saying? If it's not a rush and you kind of have your plan and it's something that you could like chip away at a little at a time, all of a sudden, before you know it, at the end of a few weeks, a few months, a couple years, you're going to turn around and be like, I think I have too much stuff. But it's because you started small. And the fifth step, this is probably the easiest, I think, as long as you're not freaking out. Start small, but be consistent. What if every time you went to the grocery store, you set aside like an extra $10 or $20 that you're going to spend on stuff from your list of things that you need, stuff that you know your family uses, stuff that you know you're going to use, and stuff that's going to last a long while. So if you see batteries are on sale, well, that's a good thing to stock up on. If you see canned whatever soup you like, whatever vegetables you like, whatever beans or what pasta, all those things that last a long, long time on the shelves that you know you guys eat, we just came back from Walmart and mac and cheese was on sale. My kids could live on mac and cheese. I don't want them to live on that, but it's super easy. It was like less than a dollar a box. I'm like, I'll take all of my money and give me all of the boxes you got, because I know it's not going to go to waste. I know that it'll last on the shelves. The point being is, if every time you went to your local pharmacy and you spent a few dollars on either some health and hygiene, toothbrush, toothpaste, soap, shampoo, you know what stuff you use, but you spend a few bucks and you stock up on the areas where you're lacking or you're slacking. Slacking and lacking, lacking and slacking. Again, if you start small and you set like a small budget that it doesn't hurt when you spend that few bucks, and you know that you're putting in that not for what we're going to use right now, not for next month, but like for just in case. And then before you know it, like, hey, if I buy mac and cheese, and the last time it was on sale, I bought a whole bunch, well, I moved that stuff to the front and I put the new ones I just bought behind that. I'm a firearms instructor. I go through a lot of ammunition. So like I stock up on it as best I can, as often as I can. And lately it's been a lot of money. And that's if you can find it. So now it's kind of like that's the other balance is, you know, supply and demand. Yes, it's expensive, but at least I could find, you know, shotgun ammunition. Or I teach, so if my student says that I don't have it, like they don't have it, then I can't teach them. And if I can't teach them, I can't make the money. So I'm like, if I see it, even if it's at a premium, I'll buy it because I need it. Do you understand the difference? Hey, I just want to say thanks to all my old subscribers, new subscribers, especially you guys who've been here since the beginning. Thank you so much for like just sharing these videos and spreading the word and helping the channel grow. It's a school, man. I want it to help people. That's really the most important thing. So if you know somebody that a new prepper or somebody that you want to see start prepping and you think they might benefit from some of this stuff, hey, pass it along, man. It helps me, it helps you, it helps them. And it's good karma, man. It's people helping people. All right? Thanks so much, Warriors. I really appreciate it. So again, quick review. The first thing you need is a goal. What is it that you and your family are preparing for? So if it is something as simple as the power going out or breaking down on the side of the road or the zombie apocalypse, set a goal, like as clear of a goal as you can. Two is make your lists. Go through the five categories of food and water, clothes, health and hygiene items, comfort items, and survival gear for your goal, the thing that you're anticipating and the thing that you want to be prepared for, and go through the things that you know you and your family use. Three is once you got that list, go through your inventory of all the stuff that you already have so you don't go buy it again or buy more of it, or you spend money on stuff that you already have and you're not spending it on stuff that you really need. Four is shop on sale. Remember that if you're not in a rush and it's not an emergency, you got all the time in the world to go back to your list and see the stuff that you need and look for it on sale or wait for it to go on sale or look for some coupons and make your dollar go as far as you can. And five is start small, but be consistent. Set a few dollars aside so that every time you go to the grocery store or the pharmacy or wherever, you take a few dollars and you get a few extra of the things that you need. Again, hoping that it's on sale, then using the coupons, saving as much money as you can or stretching your dollar as far as you can, but be consistent. Don't go nuts. Don't get yourself in credit card debt or spend a mortgage payment or take money that was supposed to go to something more important and put it towards this stuff. But start small and be consistent. Well, if you made it this far and you like what I'm teaching and preaching, go ahead and give me a thumbs up and like this video. If you're loving it, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. And if you gotta have it, make sure you hit the bell notification button and the little spot where it says all notifications so YouTube will let you know when the next video drops. If you're really digging it and you want more, you can find me on all social media platforms at 5 Elements Tactical. That's all I got for now, Warriors. So until our paths cross again, pray for the best, prepare for the rest. I'm Kyoshi Dave Herman with 5 Elements Tactical Training. Thanks for watching.